Na-receive ko na po itong prize from Sir David. Thank you so much, sir. I pray na madami pa po kayong matulungan at ma-inspire. Subscribe na po kayo sa kanyang YouTube channel and join us in our Facebook group page, Sir Dave's Classroom. Thank you so much, sir, and God bless.
Next, requirement number 6. YUM invests 288,750 for 1/4 interest in the firm. Goodwill is to be recorded. Explicitly sinabi, goodwill method ang gagamitin. Okay? Sinabi. So, 420,210 plus 288,750, lahat ay given for contribution. So, 918,750. If YUM wants 1/4, then yung natitira para dun sa dalawa, 3/4 therefore. Okay? So, dividing yung dalawa, yung total nitong dalawa, 420 plus 210, that is 630 by 3/4, and 288,750 by 1/4. Kung ano yung mas malaki, yun yung ating total agreed capital. So, kung naalala mo, sabi natin for bonus method sa ating chapter 2. Okay. And chapter 2, okay, formation, palakihan method. Ayan. Kung sining mas malaki, siya yung nanalo. Therefore, the difference between 1,155,000 and 918,750 would be the amount of our goodwill. So that is 236,250. Okay. Since same lang yan, zero, that means to say that the goodwill goes to the old partners, 177,187.5, 59,062.5, all based on how they divide profits and losses, 3:1. So, meron ka na nung mga may check, ayan, and then zero ito, ibig sabihin, ito po pwede mong idagdag dito to come up with 597,187.5 and 269,062.5, journal entries. Debit cash, credit YUM capital, 288,750. Debit goodwill for the recognition of the goodwill. Credit Dave capital, 177,187.5 to recognize Dave's share in the goodwill. Then credit Dan capital, 59,062.5. Under the goodwill method, one must produce a positive difference between the total agreed capital and the total contributed capital. So class, this is just the more formal explanation of the things that we have been talking about kanina pa. Alright? We now go to your requirement number 7. YUM invests 175,000 again for 1/4 interest in the firm. The assets of the partnership are fairly valued except for land account, which is overvalued daw yung land before YUM's admission. So, bago yung pagtanggap ng kanyang investment, sabi ni Dave tsaka ni Dan, oh, wait ka lang muna. Ayusin muna namin yung affairs namin, particularly yung overvaluation sa land, bago namin ikaw tanggapin para malinis tayo. So, 175, okay, in the eyes of an outsider. Outsider pa siya until she becomes a partner. 1/4, 700,000 ang total capital after adjustment. Okay? 805,000. Paano naging 805,000? Class, bago siya tanggapin, 420 at saka 210 yan. So, 630. Including yung investment niya na 175, kanya naging 805. So, if in the eyes of the incoming partner, 175,000 is a fair outlay to acquire 1/4, then 175,000 in itself is the 1/4. Okay? So, kasali yung 175 dun sa whole or the 100%. Are you following? Then, 175 over divided by 1/4 is 700,000. Whole, kasama yung 175 dyan. Therefore, you must compare it with the before adjustment also. Kasama din yung 175. Are you following? Alright, so 805, the 105,000 therefore is the overvaluation of the asset, particularly the land. So ibabawas yon dun sa dalawa using their old profit and loss ratio. Could you please check that out? Tama ba yung 105,000 times 3 over 4? That is correct. Also the 26,250. So going into our accessidip method, na-adjust na natin yung capital balances ni Dave at saka ni Dan. Dave has 341,250. Ayun. 183,750. Ayon, sundan mo yung sequencing natin tulad ng pag-check natin dito. Sunod, 175,000 kayam. Ito yon. Then the total is 700,000. May iba pa bang sinabi dyan? Wala na. Hindi din nagsabi na kung ilan yung ating total agreed capital. Ano pa? Since 175,000 yung binigay niya, and the capital credit is also 175,000. O, ibig sabihin yan, zero yung difference dito. 341,250, na-adjust na kasi class yung asset dito eh. And there is no other telling of any agreement that you can find in requirement number 7. So, ibig sabihin, kung 341,250 yan, this must also be 183,750. So, ang nangyari, in effect, is the net investment method. Again, the requirement did not tell you to use the net investment method. You just discovered by solving the problem. Okay? How do we journalize this one? I-journalize muna natin yung overvaluation dito, yung ibinawas kanina. So, debit the capital accounts of the old partners and credit the asset account that is overvalued. Debit cash, credit capital account for YAM. Since the capital account of YAM was used to determine the total agreed capital, an adjustment was made to the land account to adhere to that figure, then the total agreed capital and the combined contributed capital are equal. Aside from zero difference between the total agreed capital and the total contributed capital, 700,000 total agreed capital times 1/4 is 175. Agreed capital to YAM, okay, which is also the amount of her contributed capital. This spells zero difference sa total, zero difference for YAM, which means that there is no capital transfer from her or to her. Hindi siya nasaktan, hindi din siya nasiyahan. So, net investment method ang nangyari. Requirement number 8. YAM invest 175,000 for 1/4 interest in the firm. After the admission of YAM, the partnership will have a total agreed capital of 850,000. So, binanggit, investment principles ulit. 175,000 yung contribution and 1/4 interest for 210. 175,805,000 is the total. Yung 850 dito given. The difference between the two is 45,000. Diyan yung pwesto ni goodwill. So alam na natin na may 45,000 na goodwill. Given also yung 1/4 in the problem. 850 times 1/4, 212,500. Take note of the sequencing. 212,500 less 175,000, 37,500. Class, ang total nito 45 eh. Have you following? So kung kanya na yung 37,500 doon, kanino yung iba pa? Di naturalmente yung remaining para dun sa old partners dito to be consistent with our solution, and all of this will total 45,000. Ilan ba yung tira? Di 7,500. How will the 7,500 be divided? Di 3/4, 1/4, kasi 3 is to 1. Si Dave at saka si Dan. Old partnership P&L ratio. So 5,625, 1,875, plus 420, you have your 425,625, 211,875. In this requirement, sabi dito, the total agreed capital after the incoming partner's admission is specified by the problem. 1/4 of the total agreed capital results to a higher agreed capital for YAM. 1/4 of the total agreed capital results to a higher agreed capital for YAM compared to what she contributed. Since the total agreed capital is higher than the amount or the total contributed capital, then the difference is total goodwill. Out of the total goodwill, YAM gets 37,500. Alam na natin yon because that is the difference between YAM's 212,500, eto yon, and 175,000. Thus, yung tira na 7,5 ay kay old partners using their old profit and loss ratio. Requirement number 9. Yan. Nakakaraos din tayo, tama? Tsaga-tsaga lang, tulad ng sabi natin lagi. Do not give up on your dream. Okay? Kailangan masigasig ka. Kailangan lahat ng efforts mo papunta doon sa kung ano yung gusto mong ma-achieve. You must make sure that every little thing that you do contributes that it counts. Okay? Dapat marunong kang mag-budget ang time mo. Yan yung sabi natin doon pa lang sa discussions natin sa part 1. Yan ang pinaka mahalagang resource mo, yung time. That is why do not waste it. Second to the last, requirement number 9. YAM invest 175,000 investment principles for only a 160 interest in the firm. The 15,000 discrepancy will be a bonus to the old partners. Malinaw. All the parties concerned also agreed to recognize 20,000 goodwill. Aba, may binigay na bonus, may binigay din na goodwill. Sir, po pwede ba yon? Eh, ano magagawa natin? Yun yung gusto ng partners. Diba sabi natin, ang pinakaunang priority dyan, for as long as hindi illegal, hindi naman siya against public customs, public policy, morals, eh yung agreement. So, you must find a way to take into account all of the agreements and give effect to those agreements due to the good reputation that the old partnership had established. Alright? Walang sinabi kung anong method, basta i-implement mo yung usapan nila. Yun ang sabi. 420, 210, nagbigay siyam ng 175. So, lalagay mo, 175,000. So, i-total mo, 805,000 ang lalabas. Ano pa? May sinabi pa ba? Dapat daw may goodwill na 20,000. So, lagay mo, goodwill, 20,000. So, 20,000 plus 805,000, that is 825,000. Alright? Ano pa? This is a little bit out of the ordinary. Pero nangyayari ba? Eh, oo. Eh, yan yung gusto ng partners na mangyari. Eh. So, 20,000, 805 dito, 825 naman doon. Ano pa sabi? 15,000 discrepancy should be bonus to the old partners. Sabi niya, gusto kong masaktan. Gusto daw niyang masaktan for the benefit of the old partners as a bonus to the old partners. So, ibig sabihin, masasaktan siya ng 15, the 175 becomes 160. Alright? So, you have here, positive 20, negative 15, yung matitira therefore para doon sa dalawa. Alright? So, itong 26,250, itong 8,750, paano nangyari yan? Una, yung bonus na gustong ibigay ni Yam, 15,000, 15,000, paghahatian yung dalawa, Dave at Dan, 3/4 sa'yo, 1/4, so 11,250, 3,750, right? Yung goodwill naman na 20,000, nakatali na, okay, sure na negative 15 itong kay Yam dito, so hindi nagagalaw yan, negative 15 na yan. So ang maghahati dyan ay si Dave at saka si Dan ulit. So, 20,000 times 3/4, 20,000 times 1/4. So, that is 15 and 5 for Dave and Dan respectively. So, yung bonus ni Dave na 11,250 dito plus yung 15,000 naman dito, yun yung 26,250. 3,750 dito and 5,000 dito, yan yung 8,750 natin dito sa taas. So, these are the computations of these figures. Cash, 175,000 coming from YAM to the partnership books. Credit, 160 to YAM. Credit, Dave Capital for 11,250. Credit, Dan Capital for 3,750. Ito yung mga yun, yung figures na yun. Okay? And debit goodwill 20,000, si Dave at Dan din ang naghati. Therefore, eto naman yung figures na yon, the 15,000 and the 5,000. These are our entries for the requirement number 9. From the start, it has been made clear that the governing, general governing rule in partnership is the agreement between the parties as long as there is no conflict with law, blah, 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 etc. Since the incoming partner agreed to contribute one amount and be credited for another amount which is lesser, then so shall it be. Yun yung usapan eh. In addition, the partners have agreed to recognize goodwill as a prelude to the admission of YAM. As to the appropriateness of goodwill recognition in all the illustrative problems, na justify na natin yan. Okay? Please see succeeding discussions on comparison between bonus method and the goodwill method. Requirement number 10. YAM invest 140,000. Dave and Dan believes that YAM will bring favorable business climate as a new partner and therefore agreed to recognize 30,000 goodwill in YAM's favor. 30,000 goodwill. At the same time, the parties agreed to give Yam a 15,000 bonus ulit, alright? No method is specified and neither goodwill nor bonus method could be assumed exclusively. Hindi po pwedeng i-assume mong goodwill method yan kasi may bonus eh. Ang sabi natin sa goodwill method, there is no bonus. Ang sabi natin sa bonus method, there is no goodwill. So dito, in this case, you cannot exclusively assume either the bonus method or the goodwill method. Okay? Agreement method ang nangyayari dito. So, 140 ang bigay niya. So, lalagay mo 140 given yung 420 tsaka 210. May sequencing tayo dito, class, oh. Naka-number. Then, you total it becomes 770. Ano pa? Sinabi, may goodwill na 30. O, di 30. Sulat mo dito. This becomes therefore 800 kasi 30 plus 770 is 800,000. Alright? Next, kung 800,000 yan, 800,000 ito, alright? Then 45,000 naman ito, then 140 plus 45 is 185,000. Paano na nga ba naging 45,000 yan? E inattributan siya ng goodwill na 30. Binigyan pa siya ng bonus na 15. So 45, ito. Bonus at saka goodwill. So 140, 185,000. So if that is 30 and this is 45, o dyan pa lang alam mo na. Kung positive ito at dapat ang ending ng lahat ng to ay positive 30,000 lamang dito, then the remaining therefore na 15,000 doon should be negative para consistent na 30,000 dito sa baba. Such that, negative 15 ang total nitong dalawang to, negative 15 si Dave at saka si Dan, at saka positive 45 naman itong si isa. Okay? Negative 15, saka positive 45. So, yung negative 15 na yon, that is the bonus to be taken from Dave and Dan in favor of Yam. Right? So, as usual, yung hatian, 3:1 according to their old profit and loss ratio. So, cash, 140,000 yung binayad ni Yam. Credit capital, 140 to Yam. Goodwill na 30. Okay, yung capital transfer because of the bonus from Dave and Dan papunta kay Yam, 45,000. That is our requirement number 10. Comparison of bonus and goodwill methods. The bonus method adheres to the historical cost concept and is often used in accounting practice. It is objective in that it establishes total capital of the new partnership at an amount based on actual considerations received from the new partner. The bonus method indirectly acknowledges the existence of appreciation of assets and or goodwill by giving a bonus to either the original or the new partners. The goodwill method results in the recognition of an asset implied by a transaction rather than recognizing an asset actually purchased. So, bonus method, goodwill method. Historically, goodwill has been recognized only when purchased so that a more objective measure of its value is established. Ito actually yung point ng new standard.